Welcome to a new Team CGC 9.8 video. So today I wanted to reach out to the team and ask everyone for a little bit of help just deciding which CGC 9.8 comic book I should buy next. So we'll get into an analysis here of five CGC 9.8 comic books. Just let me know in the comments below, you know, which one you think is the best or which one you think I should buy. Also too, I just recently purchased a new CGC 9.8 comic book. And really, just kind of in the last couple hours here, getting the deal done, I guess. So we'll get into that one at the end of the video as a bit of a bonus. Okay, but getting into some CGC 9.8 comics here that I've really considered, and I kind of want them all, to be honest, but, you know, in reality, you usually got to narrow it down to one or two. First one on the list is a Darth Vader 3 variant in the CGC 9.8. Yeah, this is the Larroca variant. The 1 of 25 variant. Yeah, I really love this cover. Obviously, all those classic vibes for sure. So I think one of the great things about this variant is it's kind of the only variant or only more rare version of a Darth Vader 3 in the first print, which is the first appearance of Dr. Aphra. So you really like that. Like a lot of these big key issues, a lot of times they'll have like 5 or 10 variants, and it's like, wow, like which one do I collect? And there's so much variety, whereas, you know, this one, there's only one to collect. Like, you want the more rare version of Darth Vader 3. It's this Larroca variant in the CGC 9.8. So, yeah, with Dr. Aphra, you know, clearly they're, like, setting her up to be sort of the next Luke Skywalker. Like, this cover kind of says it all. Well, you know, with Darth Vader kind of lending the classic hand like he did to Luke. But, okay, in the 9.8 here, 264 9.8s in the blue label. 50%, the 9.8 percentage there, so half of them are CGC 9.8s. So you'd maybe like to see that a little bit more rare, but not too bad. So, you know, I want this one really bad, but, you know, it's not really in my nature to kind of go after a really hot CGC 9.8, so that's what really makes me want to pause on this one right now, because Star Wars books are just scorching hot right now. Like, Mandalorian is the thing right now. It's the most popular thing to watch. So, you know, I think you probably want to be a little bit careful on some of these Star Wars books, you know, long term, certainly. You know, maybe if you want to flip them, that might be a little bit different. But so the Darth Vader 3 variant in the CGC 9.8, right now they're about 1,100. And you know, maybe even up to 1,200, kind of in that range in the 9.8 if you want it right now. Really, seeing this one in, let's call it like the last 8 to 10 months, it was about a 500, you know, right around 500 bucks, 500, maybe up to 550 for quite a bit. And I would say maybe 4 months ago, it really, you know, took off and got up to like 810, where, or sorry, let's call it 8 to 850, many had kind of sold. And you know, Mandalorian is so popular, there's some rumors of a Dr. Aphra, I think, going on as well. So now we're getting that next leg up from kind of 800 to 1,100, I would say. So, you know, these rare variants, though, they do have a really high ceiling. Like, I mean, the ultimate sort of version of that is the Ultimate Fallout 4 variant in the CGC 9.8, which I think is kind of selling for like 6 to 7 or 8 thousand, kind of in that range, just a very expensive one. So, you know, 1,100 does seem kind of expensive, but in the context of, you know, maybe the future upside of this one, it might not. But still, not really in my nature to go after hot ones, so it'll be tough to decide. Okay, next one here is an Uncanny X-Men number 133. Yeah, this is just a classic Wolverine book to collect in the CGC 9.8, I think. And I do like my Wolverine books. And yeah, this is one of these somewhat affordable ones, but a really serious CGC 9.8 investment grade book, I think. Because, you know, this one, it's basically the first solo Wolverine story. So it's certainly a minor key, I would say, maybe even getting into major key territory. Great Wolverine cover. It predates Wolverine Limited Series number 1. So I've always liked this one more than Wolverine Limited Series number 1. Funny you say that. I do have a Wolverine Limited Series number 1 in the CGC 9.8, but I sort of bought that when they were pretty cheap, like 2 years ago or so it was. But with Uncanny X-Men 133, it's a much better collector item in the CGC 9.8 than Wolverine Limited Series number one, I think. And it predates Wolverine Limited Series number one for the first solo Wolverine story, I guess you could call it. 237 CGC 9.8s in the blue label for this one, whereas Wolverine Limited Series, it's like 2,000. It's in the 2,000s. It's like 2,500 something in the 9.8. So this one's a lot harder to find, a lot more rare. For a while there, they were similar priced, and there's been more than a couple videos where I've had these kind of side by side. Like, yeah, you know what? I think X-Men 133 is a great buy at like 450 to 500. But I'm seeing some of the completed listings a little bit higher than that lately. But there's only 237 out there. You like that from a collector perspective. 14.5%, the 9.8 ratio. This is a pretty old book, but still, of all graded copies, 14.5% of them are 9.8. So that's a nice rarity. So some completed listings I'm seeing for X-Men 133. $695 one sold. I think that was a good deal. There was a couple others, I believe I went over that. They were the sort of buy it now or best offers on eBay. So I think sort of, $695 one sold. I think that's a good deal. Maybe even up to $750 if you wanted this one. So this one's come quite a long way too. I remember it going for $400 to $450. Even I remember, you know, over a year ago, maybe they were about $350. So this one's done well. It is pretty collectible, and you know, it might still be worth it for me to get in there. I think, you know, for around $700, if I can pull it off with an X-Men 133. So collectible. I've wanted this one for a long time too. I think I've had it on quite a few want list videos in the past, to be honest. Okay, next one here though. It's a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 95, the SDCC variant. Yeah, this one is when Jennika becomes a new Ninja Turtle, and I think that's a pretty big moment in kind of modern comics. You get, a fifth addition to the Ninja Turtles, which were always like four turtles for the longest time. So this SDCC variant, I think there was only like 200 or 250 printed, I think it was. So it's really rare, and I think this is probably one you want to be early on, and, you know, obviously the variants. The Darth Vader 3 variant is over, 1,100 in the 9.8. This one's not there yet, but it's certainly less printed than Darth Vader 3, the Larroca variant. This one's less printed, so if Jennika ever blew up, you know, made it on the big screen or something like that, I just see some pretty big upside in this one. And I should have brought my 95s out. I have the Eastman variant, which is kind of the mid-tier variant, and a couple of the cover A's, which is a pretty cool cover. But we'll get into some prices here quick. There's only 68 CGC 9.8s in the blue label for this one. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 95, the SDCC variant, San Diego Comic-Con variant. 91.9% the CGC 9.8 percentage there. So almost all of them are 9.8s. This one's pretty much brand new. Went straight to CGC. So it was pretty tough to find this one in the blue label. There's just as many signature series ones. I think there might even be more. Yeah, I forgot to look at that. But seeing some signature series ones sell. One was for $760. I believe it was a sign-in sketch too, looking pretty cool. Another one I saw sell for $425. And this one, it was done in like a gray ink, so the signature didn't really show up that well. So that's the only reason why I could think, you know, that went for that low. Because I think that's a really great price for the signature series one of this one in the 9.8. But I think even in the blue label, like $400 to $500 would be a really good price. But I have a feeling that, you know, it might even take $600 or maybe even more to grab this one right now. Yeah, being the more rare variant of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 95, which is, I think, a really good collectible modern book. Like, you know, moderns I almost disregard completely, but the fifth edition to the Ninja Turtles, yeah, like that's probably a decent modern key to get while they're still somewhat cheap. And this being the more rare variant, yeah, this is one for me to consider. I've been on the lookout for this one, to be honest, and not too many pop up in the blue label because I'm not too much of a signature series guy, but yeah, hoping one of these pop up in the blue label for maybe around $500, and that would be really tough to say no to. Okay, next one's a big one. It's a Venom number 3, the third printing. Yeah, you get the first full appearance of Knull in this one with the, you know, super eye-appealing third print cover that was pretty low-printed as well. And it's basically the first Knull cover and, you know, a super collectible. I really like this one. Made a whole video, yeah, talking about, you know, I think now it's a decent time to buy. With this one got so hot in the last, let's call it 6 months, you know, about 4 to 6 months ago. These in the 9.8 were selling for about $800. Notice that one had sold for $399.99 in the 9.8. So I wanted to make that video like, hey, you know, they're not 800 anymore. Now might be the time to consider this one. So Venom number 3 third print in the blue labels 9.8. There's 1,006 CGC 9.8s out there. That's quite a lot for like a low printed book. Yeah, that's, you know, still quite a bit. But Knull is, you know, basically the most popular modern villain going right now. So 84.8% the 9.8 ratio, so almost all of them. Again, a new book going straight to CGC pretty much. But mentioned that a $399.99 one sold in a buy it now, like someone just having a real attractive buy it now, it sold in like a day. That one made me sort of make the video, and I do think right now, you know, for me, this is one that I could grab on a pullback, or I, you know, making that video, I am sort of, you know, keeping on top of my searches for this one. There actually is an auction on eBay right now. I think it was at like $380 or something like that. And I would, for me, I'm just going to probably be, you know, try to be pretty picky with this one and hopefully get it under $400. So it'll be interesting to see. And if you really want this one, yeah, check out that auction. I'm pretty sure it ends in a day or two. But one also sold for $485. That was just in the last couple days here, I think, or a week or two. So, yeah, people paying up to $485. $400, you know, I think is a pretty decent, a great buy, actually, you know, for this one. But super collectible, and I am considering this one. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think about Venom number 3 third print, if I should buy it, in the comments below. Okay, last one here is, we just talked about it on a recent video, but it did really make me think of, you know, it's a really great one that I want. Amazing Spider-Man number 210 in the CGC 9.8. First appearance of Madam Web. Yeah, I think it was the last video we talked about this one. And just, I think just hashing it out on that video was like, I was like, I do want this one. Because I really like where it's trending in the 9.8 percentage. Because I sort of know the history of this one. 131 CGC 9.8s in the blue label. Not bad at all. First Madam Web, only 131 of them. That's awesome. 12.9% the 9.8 ratio, so of all graded copies, 12.9% are CGC 9.8s. So when I first started following this one and kind of wanted it like a year or two ago, there was, you know, 80 on the census maybe, not very many. And the 9.8 ratio, I'm pretty sure it was 20%. It was like 20, 21, and I think it went down to 19. But I hadn't looked at this one for a while, you know, a bit on the census, and was surprised to see it you know, trending really low because, yeah, there were those Madam Web show rumors. You know, as that goes, everyone starts to send in their, you know, raw copies to CGC when that those rumors pick up, which they did. So not a lot of those came back 9.8. So this is trending to kind of be a pretty rare one in the 9.8. So I really love the cover too. And I mentioned that on the video yesterday. But for Amazing Spider-Man 210 in the 9.8, I think right around $735 one sold for. Yeah, I think if, you know, I'm going to keep an eye out for some popping up in an auction maybe, and, you know, maybe a $760 bid will take it down or something like that if I want to be super aggressive and want it now. But yeah, I think maybe even under $700 is doable on this one, but one selling for $735. Yeah, I'm really considering this one. I love the Amazing Spider-Man sort of you know, trade dress, and I have most of the keys in Amazing Spider-Man during this period, and because I like the cover of this one a lot too, Madam Web's pretty cool too. I really remember her from the Spider-Man animated series in the 90s quite a bit. So yeah, just cool cover and a cool collectible in 9.8, and yeah, trending nicely in the rarity in the CGC 9.8. Okay, so that is the 5 CGC 9.8s I'm really considering buying. So let me know in the comments below which one you think I should buy. So really quick, you might be wondering, like, why did I bring out my Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 101 variant? So I ended up grabbing, just in the last little bit from a team member on Instagram, a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 101 Cover A. So this is the variant cover. I mentioned in the unbox video for this one and a couple other videos that I really like the Cover A cover as well. It's like a black cover with the Ninja Turtle team on the cover. So someone on the team was letting me know that he like sent one into CGC and he would probably sell it for me, and he ended up like totally keeping his promise, and I ended up grabbing one of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 101 in the Cover A. So have a look on the census for this one. There's only 8 CGC 9.8s in the blue label. So yeah, this is one where right away everyone initially went to this cover because this is the first appearance of Lita and Mona Lisa. And on this cover, they're like on the cover. Lita's right here, the little albino kid turtle. So, you know, this one was just really collected right away because it's her first appearance. She's on the cover, and you get that. But I just really like the eye appeal of the Cover A cover, so I think it could be pretty well collected over time. And it's a decent one to get in here right now, I think, if you can get it under $100. You know, this is a brand new comic, so you don't really want to rush out there. I think, you know, 70 to 90 is like a really fair range. I ended up paying $85. Yeah, and from a Canadian team member too. So pretty great shipping from Canada. So it'll be here pretty quick too. But it was 80%, the CGC 9.8 percentage, but there's only 8 graded. Another thing too, this one, it's a black cover. I think this has potential to be a pretty tough black cover to get a 9.8 in, because a lot of times the black covers that are really plain like this, they show the spine dinks like so easy. So I have a feeling over time this one could become a little bit more rare in the 9.8 too. But either way, still a first appearance, it's still the Cover A, and it's a great cover with eye appeal, although Lita is not on the cover, so that's the downside. But $85 I think was a pretty fair deal. Like, I didn't even negotiate, that was his first offer, and I was like, that's pretty much what I was thinking. So I think this is kind of a cool one, and I'm pretty pumped about this one. An affordable one that I just purchased. So of the 5, though, certainly kind of more bigger keys, I would think, of the 5 we got into. So definitely let me know in the comments below what you think is the best one I should go after. Okay, so thanks for watching today. I really appreciate all the support from everyone. If you haven't already, would invite you to join the team and subscribe to Team CGC 9.8. Hit the bell for all the latest notifications. Add me on Instagram and Twitter as well. All the links in the description below. But this was a fun one, and I wanted to make like a short list of what, you know, CGC 9.8s I'm really like considering buying, and I'm kind of doing the searches for and everything like that. Quite often. So really looking forward to reading everyone's opinion, hopefully in the comments below. Message me on Instagram too if you did have any questions or just wanted to contact me directly. Okay, thanks so much for watching though, as always, team, and I'll see you on the next one.